I'm here to talk a little about the miscarriages today. Now, what's a miscarriage? Miscarriage is a loss of pregnancy before the period of viability, which we consider to be 28 weeks in India currently. Now, miscarriages are quite common, in fact, much more than people actually realize they are. 1 in 5 pregnancies lost to a miscarriage. In fact, most of the miscarriages happen even before a woman realizes that she's pregnant. Recurrent miscarriage, which is, you know, loss of 3 or more pregnancies in a row, is much more uncommon and it affects about 1 in 100 pregnancies. What are the causes of miscarriage? The miscarriage can be caused due to a lot of factors and it is usually not possible to identify a particular cause in every case. Now, most of the miscarriages happen in the first trimester of pregnancy, that is the first 3 months of pregnancy. In fact, 3 out of every pregnancy that is lost during the first 3 months. Out of which, again, about 2/3 are caused due to some chromosomal disorder. Now, chromosomes are the building blocks of life. Sometimes things go wrong at the point of conception so that the fetus doesn't get enough chromosomes or get more chromosomes. Obviously, the fetus cannot develop well and this leads to miscarriage. The second thing that might commonly cause a miscarriage is some problem with the development of the placenta. Placenta is the vital link between the mother and the fetus. And hence, an abnormally developing placenta will obviously lead to miscarriages. There's another important cause of miscarriage, something called as antiphospholipid syndrome, which we are able to identify in an increasing number of patients nowadays. Now, antiphospholipid syndrome is an autoimmune disorder in which the mother's body rejects the fetus as something outside. So now that, as I said, is another important cause. There are a lot of things which increase your risk of having a miscarriage. Important is age. In a woman over the age of 30, 1 in 10 pregnancies end in a miscarriage, whereas the same doubles as a woman becomes older. Between 35 to 40 years of age, about 2 in every 10 pregnancies is lost, and above the age of 45, half of the pregnancies are actually lost. The other risk factors are, of course, obesity, smoking, use of alcohol, use of illicit drugs in pregnancy. Miscarriages in second trimester are quite uncommon, you know, about 1 in 4 pregnancy losses happen in the second trimester. Most of the second trimester losses are due to some chronic health problem that the lady is facing, something like an uncontrolled diabetes, thyroid problem, could be hypo or hyperthyroid, uncontrolled blood pressure, kidney diseases, lupus syndromes. All these which actually cause problems to the baby can increase the risk of having a miscarriage. The other problems could be some problems with your womb. The womb could be shaped abnormally. There could be some other problems like fibroids in your womb. Or it could be a weakness in the neck of your womb, which we call as the cervix, that increases the risk of your second trimester miscarriages. Some medications also increase the risk of miscarriage. Some of the common painkillers that we use increase the risk of miscarriage and hence should not be used on your own. It is always better used under supervision. Other drugs like methotrexate, which is used in the treatment of rheumatoid arthritis, some drugs like retinoids, which are very commonly used in the treatment of acne, also increase the risk of miscarriage and hence have to be not used during your pregnancy. It is very important to know when you have to immediately report to your doctor. If you have any bleed, any watery discharge, or any crampy abdominal pain that comes on and off during your early pregnancy, it could be a sign of miscarriage and you must report to the doctor immediately. I think we should also talk about a lot of myths and misconceptions that are associated with miscarriage very, very commonly. It's very, very important to remember that there is no evidence that a miscarriage is associated with the emotional state of the mother, like she is very depressed or she is very stressed out. Working during pregnancy causes a miscarriage is one of the biggest myths. Working, climbing stairs, lifting or straining oneself does not lead to miscarriage. Another important thing is having sex during pregnancy can cause miscarriage. It's a big myth. It does not. Air travel during pregnancy, eating spicy food, all these are not linked to having a miscarriage at all. Coming to the prevention of miscarriages. Since in most of the cases it is very difficult to identify a cause for miscarriage, it is very difficult to prevent all the miscarriages from happening. But there are certain things that you can do to reduce your risk of having a miscarriage. Most important is to start the pregnancy on a healthy weight. It is important not to smoke, not to use alcohol, drugs, and also to limit the intake of caffeine during your pregnancy. The caffeine should be limited to about 200 milligram per day, and that would work out to be about 2 cups of tea or 2 cups of coffee, and also to restrict your chocolate intake in your pregnancy. It is better to avoid getting some infectious diseases like rubella, toxoplasmosis. If you have cats in your house, it is important to see that it is not you who disposes of the litter and ask somebody else to do it, or to use rubber gloves when you have to do it yourself. There are some foods that are to be avoided during pregnancy, like raw or partially cooked meat or eggs. Certain kinds of fish like shark, swordfish are to be avoided. Certain kinds of cheese are to be avoided during pregnancy. And as I said, it is important to restrict the intake of caffeine during the pregnancy. There are some treatable causes that can be very well treated during the pregnancy. The most important of them is the antiphospholipid syndrome. Women who are diagnosed with antiphospholipid syndrome usually present with recurrent miscarriages. Now, antiphospholipid syndrome can be very well treated with a combination of aspirin and heparin, which is a drug that we use to prevent the clotting of blood in the ladies. Now, another important factor that can be treated to prevent the miscarriage is, of course, a weakened cervix. Whenever a woman is diagnosed with a weak cervix, we can put a strong stitch around the cervix, which holds back the pregnancy and hence prevents a miscarriage. What is important to remember is that miscarriage is usually a one-off event for a woman. Even those with a recurrent miscarriage, that is having three or more losses in pregnancy, 60% of them go on to conceive normally and deliver a healthy baby.